Follow the traces. Explore roots deep. Learn from the past. Futures to reap. Stay tuned for Qingqiao Safety. Detective. Chapter 2, Astonishing Trap Behind Generous Rewards. After Li Hui received the first task assigned by Zhou Liang, he promptly utilized his free time to visit the school library and borrow the aviation magazine. He reasoned that libraries are public spaces, and magazines are available for reading openly. Therefore, taking pictures should pose no issue. Li Hui understood that Zhou Liang sought his help because he was overseas and faced challenges in conducting the search himself. However, Li Hui searched all the reading rooms in the library and couldn't find the magazine. A few days later, during a holiday visit to his hometown, Li Hui managed to locate 8 aviation magazines in the local library. Delighted, he swiftly captured over 700 pictures with his mobile phone and promptly emailed them to Zhou Liang in a compressed package. What made Li Hui particularly happy was that Zhou Liang immediately paid him 1,800 yuan via WeChat transfer. The first 6 magazines earned him 1,000 yuan, and the last 2 magazines brought in an additional 800 yuan. Li Hui then proceeded to photograph Navy magazine and soon earned another 400 yuan. It seemed that this company was truly financially capable. Li Hui couldn't help but secretly rejoice, grateful that he had stumbled upon such an easy and profitable part-time opportunity. Soon, Zhou Liang asked Li Hui that he needed information about both the military parades of Chinese Navy's 70th anniversary and the 70th anniversary of the founding of New China. Not knowing where to find this information, Li Hui attempted to search for domestic media reports online. He sent them to Zhou Liang and received a reward of 200 yuan each time. Since then, Li Hui, who tasted the benefits, developed an unprecedented enthusiasm for work. He quickly completed several similar tasks assigned by Zhou Liang and received numerous rewards one after another. At this point, he had no doubts about earning money by running errands, and he trusted Zhou Liang even more. But then, Zhou Liang made an abnormal request in the follow-up communication, not only making Li Hui feel embarrassed but also prompting him to realize that something was amiss. Because Zhou Liang repeatedly inquired about the specific details of pilot recruitment at the military academy, he didn't ask about the admission process or what pilots do after being admitted. Instead, he focused on questions about the whereabouts of pilots after they were eliminated. These questions became increasingly targeted at internal military information, which raised suspicions since such details are not typically of interest to the general public. Only then did Li Hui become suspicious of this big brother who was overseas. It seemed less like he was looking for someone to run errands and more like he was seeking inside information. In a chat, Li Hui jokingly asked Zhou Liang, "Are you a spy?" However, the other party did not provide a direct answer and only replied with a simple emoji. Although Li Hui had many doubts and felt uneasy, the school's final exams were approaching. He deemed his studies as a top priority, and decided to temporarily set aside his contact with Zhou Liang to concentrate fully on preparing for his exams. However, Li Hui was unaware that every action he took and every piece of information he provided had already become the focus of state security agency. His act of sending photos abroad was immediately detected by security agency, and they began tracking the trajectory of his actions. After the final exam, Li Hui was about to breathe a sigh of relief when he received a call from the school counselor. On the phone, the counselor's voice was serious and nervous, "Li Hui, we need to talk to you." Li Hui's heartbeat suddenly accelerated, and he felt an inexplicable panic. He didn't know what was going on, but he could guess that it wasn't simple. Immediately afterward, investigators from the Zhengzhou City State Security Bureau took Li Hui away on suspicion of illegally providing information and data to overseas organizations and seized his mobile phone and computer. Li Hui's world collapsed instantly. He couldn't believe that his actions would have such consequences. He wanted to explain and prove his innocence, but he knew that it was too late, and he had to take due responsibility for this. In fact, before Li Hui's case occurred, Chen Wei, a sophomore at another university in Zhengzhou, had already encountered a similar situation. Unlike Li Hui, who is gullible to strangers, Chen Wei appears to be very vigilant. He was very interested in China's politics, culture, and military, so after being added as a friend by Zhou Liang, who claimed to be a member of a certain civil society organization, he quickly realized that what the other party wanted was unusual. After exchanging several chat messages, he concluded that he discovered the core method of the other party, in the name of a part-time job, using high salary to induce students to collect information on China's military, troops, and other related fields. Therefore, while Chen Wei calmly stabilized the other party and deceived the other party, he actively sought contact with state security agency and reported the situation he had grasped. What is Zhou Liang's true identity? This seems to be a trap set for college students. What kind of conspiracy is hidden? Please stay tuned for the next issue, Detective of Qingxiao Safety.